the works will testify. Even when men do not believe, the works will testify with a high-pitched voice. Even when men don't believe. You see, our problem as South Africans, we became unfortunate that South Africa was colonized by religious people. That's why the Christianity that we receive was but a counterfeit of the real thing. What am I talking about? South Africans, we were absorbed by churches like
Enghie,
Methodists, churches who don't believe in the move of the Spirit. They don't even believe in prophetic power. Unfortunately, the root of South Africans was faulty because we were colonized by people who do not believe in God. That's why we don't know prophecy. That's why we don't know prophet. That's why it's very easy for you to doubt what men of God is saying, or to feel offended when he tell you about things to come. You know, prophets have been sent to testify to the truth, to reveal to you what is yet to come, what is happening, and what has happened. But this type of people, when you don't have the grace to know who they are, you constantly find yourself in conflict, in wrestle with these people, because they are strange creatures. People who tell you things that have not happened, on a later stage they come to pass. If you are a normal Christian, you can't understand these people, because they've been sent from above. You've been listening to testimonies. There is a baby that will be born between you and your wife, but there will be a struggle. What is man of God talking about? He give you the end result. He give you a vision of the end result, but he also revealed the process that it will not be easy. Imagine a woman with a small womb and a husband with low sperm count. There's no hope for a child. You were listening to testimony here. I came to them. I'm not in their bedroom, but I was telling them what was happening in their bedroom. I said to them, the sperm of your husband does not enter inside. Every time he releases, the sperm come out. Because there is what? The sperm is not strong enough to enter inside. And they confirmed it. But I said to them, God will do it. After deliverance, they conceive. So this is to tell you that children are not made by men. They are granted from above. You listen to this? No one can make a baby. You only participate in the process. But Jesus is the one who decides what would come out of your participation. You see how God works. And they've been stressing. This issue has been affecting them. They did not mention it, but I know as a man of God, they will be stressful sometimes. Even when they have to meet as husband and wife, they will feel like we are wasting our time. Nothing is going to happen. They will drag themselves. Is it not so?
Yes.
You people will just do it because but you know nothing will happen. But God is faithful. When the man of God has spoken, a man sent from Jesus speaks a word upon your life. Whether you believe or you doubt, it will happen.
Clap hands for Jesus.
So I want to say to you, from today, good things will happen to you.
Give glory to Jesus.
Good things. Only good things. You know, every time a prophet speaks, heaven listens and support what he's saying. So when I speak this, I'm rearranging your life. I'm saying to you, good things will happen to you from today. You know, it's not easy to believe when the word have been spoken over your life, but the results will shock you. We are going to be releasing a testimonial book. Because some of you are new, you don't know my track record as a prophet. So we are going to release a book of testimonies that have got people that have seen miraculous work through this ministry. Many things have happened. Many big things. If you believe,
how do you mean?
You overcome. If you believe,
how do you mean?
You will overcome. Let's open our Bibles. In the book of Matthews, chapter 8, I want you to read it at home, to read the whole chapter, but we'll read it from verse
33.
That's where my message is based. Are you there? Matthews chapter 8, verse 33. There is a strange force, but it will fall. There is lightning where you are, coming from your presence. No one compares to you. There is nothing where you are, kind of glory for your presence. No one compares to you. Light where you are, there is nothing where you are. There is lightning where you are.
There is lightning where you are.
Cloud of glory,
feel your presence.
Oh, oh.
No one compares to you.
You are seated, God.
You are seated on the throne, worshiped by the angels. No one compares to you.
Father, you are seated.
You are seated on the throne, worshiped by the angels.
No one
compares.
get into the message. But I've got so much to say to you. And we are going to Namibia. I don't know why Mozambique keeps coming. I think God will send us to Mozambique too. So, on the 4th of December, we'll be having a revival in Namibia. So, we are going far. As a ministry, you know, the church is very young. Last week, on the 26th of October, the church was standing 5 years. But what we have accomplished in 5 years is shockingly amazing. We managed to erect a building. We are appearing on TV. We have built toilets. We have done so much. It's not everyone who can say that. In 5 years,
clap hands for Jesus.
This is grace. I trust God that He will give me opportunity to give you as well a small portion of the living water. Water from the fountain. Imagine you drink it and everything open and you become pregnant. What can you do to your life?
Oh Jesus, I'm so in love with you. You drive me crazy, can't stop thinking about you.
Let's read. And they that kept them fled, and went their ways into the city, and told everything, and what was befallen to the possessed of the devils. And behold, the whole city came out to meet Jesus. And when they saw him, they besought him that he would depart out of their coast.
Janong badisa bathaba baya kwa motseng ba bolella tsotlhe le tsona tsaba neng ba tsenwe ke mmimiwa e busula fo batho botlhe ba motse batswa ba ya go kopanela le Jesu ya re ba mmona ba mo rapela gore a tloge monageng ya bone.
Chapter 9 verse 1. And he entered into a ship and passed over and came into his city.
Janong a palama mokoro a tshela letsha a boela kwa motseng wa gagabo.
I love what the English version says. It says, after they have rejected him, Jesus turned his back on that region and he entered into the boat and left. If I were to entitle my message this morning, I would say the element of faith. Element as tamaiso papa. The element of faith. Somebody help him. Help them. Can you help the Tswana people? The Tokoim people. I will not preach until you tell them what is element. There is lightning where you are,
cloud of glory. Feel your presence, no one compares to you. You are seated on the throne, worshipped by the angels, no one compares.
Those that went to school, what is the difference between atom and element? the difference between atom and element. Element is a finer fracture of an atom. Karolo.
Ke karolo nyana e nyane nyane
ya tumelo.
Ya tumelo.
Element.
Karolo ya tumelo.
The Bible teaches us that when Jesus entered into the land of Gadarene, he met a demon-possessed man. The Bible says they were so possessed that they were naked and they lived in the tomb. In the cemetery, this man was so possessed that they did not have place within the normal mankind. When Jesus entered in the city, he delivered this man. The demons that were inside these people entered into a swine. The swine fell on the other side of the goat. But there were men, shepherds, that were tending over the swine. When they saw this kind of power, a strange intervention of the supernatural, they were filled with fear. The Bible says they ran back into the city. When they entered, they reported a supernatural incident that have happened. Now the Bible says when the men and the woman, the community of Gadarene, came out to behold the mystery that was spoken about, they met Jesus out of fear, disbelief, and lack of faith. They asked Jesus to depart from their city. The Bible says Jesus turned his back and entered into the boat and left the place where he was told not to enter. I have realized something, that we as mankind, when we don't want Jesus to be an integral part of our lives, of our existence, Jesus will never force himself into us. Cement, which one is Paku or PPC? Go.
Worship God.
Cement. You love cement too. There is favor of business.
Clap hands for Jesus.
Pray against a trap of aging alone, because it's very prevalent in the family. This is a family curse. If husband does not die, woman don't get married. And they age alone. Pray against this trap.
Glorify God, somebody.
will promote you at work, okay? There is a supervisor promotion that is coming. You need to continue to work and be faithful, okay? There's a problem in your womb. It's small. That's why you feel heartbeat. You feel like there's something moving inside.
Yes.
But don't worry, God will do you well. There is career for you in medicine.
In medicine.
This is where your future is, in the hospital. That's where God wants you to be. Okay? So we need to pray for you.
Worship God, somebody.
You are lifted up. Jesus, you are.
You need to pray against poverty in the family. There's poverty wrecking the whole family. You need to pray against this, okay? Your story will be different. Don't allow your family background to define you.
Okay?
God will help you.
Yes, somebody glorify God.
Someone will invite you to a spiritualist church. You know what I'm talking about. I don't want to mention name of churches. Sheriff.